Well, hello, tubers. I hope you're doing well wherever you are in this crazy, crazy internet universe of madness that we have descended into because of the current crisis. So today we got to do a deep dive into the how are you? The Homes on Wheels Alliance and the Bob Wells Cheap RV Living charity. Because I get so many messages, I think in the last year I've gotten hundreds actually, of messages about this and who gets the money, how do you qualify, things like that. And I'm a bit concerned and confused too. Now, whatever you guys do, I know there's a lot of libs out there, liberals, that don't like me talking. They forget that free speech is actually for everybody, including people you disagree with. But anyway, I'm just the questioner and the messenger, so relax, it's just free speech, come on. I always offer people who don't like my free speech a one-way free trip to China so they can feel more comfy and cozy, because there are places in the world where you don't get the free speech, and if you don't like my free speech or your own free speech, yeah, come talk to me. I'll hook you up with a free one-way flight. No problem. It's the least I could do to make you feel comfortable. So let's get down to the meat of the matter. The Homes on Wheels Alliance. How are you doing? How is the money going? How's the money flowing? So, but before we even dive into how, I do know people that have actually messaged me and said, I was trapped and I needed help from Bob Wells, and he actually reached into his own pocket and gave, you know, $100 or something. And I know that has happened on many occasions. So before you get your poop in a knot, I don't want you to think that Bob doesn't actually give money to people. He actually does. So let's get that out of the way before we talk about the nonprofit charity. The Homes on Wheels Alliance is a charity that perplexes many people because I'm constantly bombarded with messages and many, many videos about who gets the monies. And I am perplexed about that too. I don't know where the money's going, and quite often these are the type of comments I get. I approached Bob. Bob said, go talk to the board members. They approach the board members and talk to them, and they go, nothing. Just a wall of silence. They don't even respond. That's a very common comment. The other one is they respond and say, sorry, got no monies, no monies, no monies for you. So I'm wondering, what is the criteria? I know they've done a couple big giveaways, but who gets this? Like, what is the criteria? Do you have to be a Bob subscriber on YouTube? Do you have to be a Homes on Wheel Patreon subscriber or something? Do you have to be a Democrat, or do you have to not be a conservative? I don't know. You know, the actual criteria of how you do this, is there a means test? Do you have to show your tax return and show that your income is below a certain threshold? You know, all these things, I'm curious about who gets the monies. I just wonder, is there salaries for the board members? Maybe they get the monies first and anything left over goes to charity. I mean, that is actually very legal. I don't want anybody to misunderstand me. You can pay a lot of money out on salaries, perfectly 100%, look at my lips, 100% legal. And if there's a little bit left over, you can give that to your charitable cause. Very legal. Now the ethics of that, that's up to you. That's up to you. That's why there are some charities that are more efficient with their charitable giving and others that are not. So, begs the question again, who gets it? Do you have to be a liberal? Do you have to be poor? Do you have to be a friend of Bob? Do you have to be a subscriber? Do you have to not be a conservative? Maybe you have to be a libertarian. I don't know. Maybe you have to be an anarchist. Maybe you have to already live in a van and you want to upgrade to a better van. I have no freaking idea. And there is actually no, you know, clear criteria published on the websites. And it's easy for Bob to say, talk to the board. I get it. Hey, he don't want to have to deal with the nonstop asking for help, because there's a lot of people out there that need help. I get it. And in the actual fashion of giving, I can't believe that the governments of the world are just raining cash down on everybody. Aside from the last video where I would match the $1,200 stimulus that Carolyn's RV Life would get, which is still on the table. So Carolyn, you get your peeps in touch with my peeps. My peeps is right here. This is my personal assistant. But you get your personal assistant in touch with me, and we'll make that happen. So what is your thoughts about this crazy debacle on the Homes on Wheels Alliance, and who's getting the money? Because the need is actually increasing day by day. And it sure would be nice that if on their website they said, you know, you got to be a Democrat, you got to be a poor person that makes under $24,000 a year, you got to be a senior, or, you know, whatever. There should be clear criteria of who gets the help. And then, you know, everybody's name goes into a basket and you do a lottery draw, because obviously you can't help everybody. But, you know, I've gotten a bunch of heat about me talking about Bob, because apparently he's like Moses, and you can't talk about Moses. Apparently free speech is dead on my channel, because I'm not allowed to talk about the Moses. So why doesn't Moses part the sea and get his vanners out through that when the sea parts? And he can help some of them out. I know his six-figure income's probably dropping right now, but he probably got a few extra shekels out there. See, I use shekels. I didn't use the dinero. It's actually not a laughing matter. Who actually qualifies to get help from the Homes on Wheels Alliance? Put your comments down below. Tell me if you have been helped, and what was the criteria that was required for you to actually receive funding and assistance? I'm perplexed. I don't know. So don't hate me, and don't hate the fact that I have democratic free rights to free speech to ask these questions. Yeah. Democracy sucks, doesn't it? We still have democracy. For now. Makes you think, doesn't it? In the meantime, folks, I want you all to stay safe. Try to be charitable if you can afford it, and keep your wheels on the ground. I'll talk to you soon. Over and out.